if we have, like, let's say a mom who's stay at home and like listening to this right now, can you give us like one or two, like, just like tips to just get started?
Yes. So if your youngest child is under the age of 5, mm-hmm. you should just go take a nap. Because here's the thing, if your youngest child is under the age of 5, like I have a grandchild at home who is almost 5 months. He's already gone through 3 sizes of clothing. He's 5 months. He's gone through 3 sizes of clothing, 3 sizes of diapers. He just started food. He already has eczema and he's allergic to something. We're already out of the laying flat things and the Dock-a-Tot. And now we're into this. I mean, whatever. You cannot organize under the age of 5. I mean, you can organize that's going to last for 4 weeks. And if you want to do it because it makes you feel better, go for it. Yeah. But if it doesn't make you feel better, survive it. Like, put the clothes in a laundry basket. It doesn't matter. By the time you clean them, they've outgrown them. It just really doesn't matter. And so do not put that. If everybody is alive and you're still happy at the end of the day, like, that is an A+. You're not going to remember how you organized any of this stuff. Now, if your kids are grade school age, this is like the perfect sweet spot from 5 to like 12, 13.
Yep.
This is like a sweet spot as a stay-at-home parent. You're able to go and volunteer at school, but yeah, you've got long enough time at home while they're still at school if they're not schooling from home. And that's when you can really focus on yourself. Mm-hmm. First, organize yourself. Your closet, your backpack or purse, your car, your bedroom, because that is where you start and end your day. And that is what you have control over.